In this video, we're continuing on with the Equations of Circles worksheet on the KutaSoftware website, picking up where we left off with number 5. Now remember, the standard form for a circle is x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals the radius squared. And that's where h, k is the center, and r is the radius. Now we need to rearrange this equation in order to look like the standard form so that we can figure out h, k, and r. So in order to do this, I'm going to move my constant to the right-hand side of my equation and the x squared to my left. So I'm going to add 20 and I'm going to add x squared to both sides. So I'm adding x squared to the left and the right, and I'm adding 20 to the left and the right. So now my new equation, now that my 20 is canceled out, I'm going to rearrange to keep my terms with y next to each other in the equation and my terms with x next to each other. So I'm going to have x squared plus 4x plus y squared minus 2y. That's going to be equal to 20. Now remember, I want this in terms of x minus some constant squared plus y minus some constant squared. So that's going to be two numbers that add to give me 4. So essentially, I'm going to be dividing 4 in half. So this will be x plus 2 squared plus y. Two numbers that add to give me negative 2 are negative 1 and negative 1. So y minus 1 squared. But look, x plus 2 times x plus 2 is equal to x squared plus 4x, but then we're still adding 2 times 2, which is 4. So I added a 4 to the left-hand side. That means I'm going to need to add a 4 to the right-hand side of my equation. So this is going to be equal to not just 20, but 20 plus 4, since we added that 4 in when we put x plus 2 squared. Now we have to look at y minus 1 squared. Y minus 1 squared is equal to y minus 1 times y minus 1, and that's y squared minus 2y, and then negative 1 times negative 1 is plus 1. So we've also added not just a positive 4, but a positive 1 to the left-hand side. So that means we're going to need to add a positive 1 also to the right-hand side. So now I'll have x plus 2 squared plus y minus 1 squared equal to 20 plus 4 plus 1, which is 25. Now you can see I have it in the terms of x minus h squared plus y minus k squared. That's equal to r squared. So my h value is a negative 2. X minus a negative 2 is the same as x plus 2. And my k value is a positive 1. And r squared is equal to 25. So when I take the square root of r squared, I'll get that r is equal to 5. So our radius is 5. So the center of our circle occurs at negative 2, 1. So negative 2, positive 1. And the radius, r, is equal to 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, drawing a straight line that's worth 5 units. Drawing another straight line of 5 units. These are points that lie on the edge of the circle. And to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now I'm going to connect all those points on the edge with my oval tool. And if you're not doing this on the computer, I recommend using a compass. But you can see my answer in number 5 is a circle with the center at negative 2, 1, and a radius of 5. So again, my steps were to get it in the form of x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. And then I could solve for h and k and r. Let's move on to number 6. Number 6 is easier than number 5. And that's because all I need to do is multiply everything by negative 1. So multiplying the left-hand side of my equation by negative 1 and multiplying the right-hand side of my equation by negative 1, I'll get that 9 is equal to y squared plus x squared. And I can rearrange this to say x squared plus y squared equals 9, which x minus 0 squared plus y minus 0 squared equals 9 is equivalent to that, because if I take away 0 from x, I get x, and if I take away 0 from y, I get y. So my h value is 0, my k value is 0, and my r squared, my radius squared, is 9. But if I take the square root of both sides, I'll get that my radius is 3. So the center of my circle occurs at point 0, 0, and the radius of my circle is 3. So going 3 up, 3 to the right, 3 down, and 3 to the left, I'll be able to connect those points to form my circle. So again, that's a circle where the center lies at 0, 0, and the radius is 3. Moving on to number 7, I'm going to have to rearrange this equation to get it in the form of x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. I need my y squared and x squared values to be positive. So I'm going to multiply everything by negative 1. So that's multiplying the right-hand side of my equation by negative 1 and the left-hand side. So negative 1 times 9 is negative 9, and that's equal to negative 1 times 2y, which is negative 2y, plus negative 1 times negative y squared, which is positive y squared, plus negative 6x times negative 1 is a positive 6x, plus negative 1 times negative x squared, or minus a negative x squared, is a positive x squared. So now I'm going to rearrange this by flipping my equation. So I'll have x squared plus 6x plus y squared minus 2y equal to negative 9. I want this in terms of x minus or plus some constant squared plus y minus or plus some constant squared. So I need to look at my coefficient of my singular variables. So the coefficient of 6x is 6. So what two numbers are the same that add to give me a positive 6? That's a positive 3. So this will be x plus 3 squared. And I need to figure out what two numbers add to give me a negative 2, and that's negative 1 and negative 1. So y minus 1 squared. So I have x plus 3 times x plus 3, and y minus 1 times y minus 1. However, x plus 3 squared plus y minus 1 squared does not equal x squared plus 6x plus y squared minus 2y. When I factor out x plus 3 squared, I'll get x squared plus 6x plus 9. And when I factor out y minus 1 squared, I'll get y squared minus 2y plus 1. So because I added a 9 and a 1 on my left-hand side, I'm going to need to add a 9 and 1 on my right-hand side of the equation. So now you can see that if I was to subtract 9 and subtract 1, then I would get my original equation. So now I'll have x plus 3 squared plus y minus 1 squared. And that's equal to negative 9 plus 9, which is 0, plus 1. So now I'm in the form of x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. That's where h is equal to negative 3, because x minus a negative 3 is the same as x plus 3, and k is equal to 1, y minus k, y minus 1, and my r squared value is 1, so if I take the square root of both sides, I'll get that my radius is equal to 1. So I have the center of my circle occurring at negative 3, 1, and I have my radius of 1. So finding negative 3, 1 on my graph, and then a radius of 1, going 1 up, 1 to the right, 1 down, and 1 to the left, and then connecting those to form the edge of my circle. Now let's move on to number 8, the last problem I'll do in this video. Now remember, I want to get this equation in standard form, so I'm going to have to rearrange. I want this to look like x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equal to r squared. So at the start, I'm going to move my constant to the right. So I'll have x squared plus y squared minus 8x minus 6y. So I'm going to also rearrange this, putting my values with x and my values with y next to each other. So I'm going to have x squared minus 8x plus y squared minus 6y equals negative 16. Now because my x squared and y squared values are positive, I do not need to worry about multiplying by a negative 1. So just like in the previous problem, we need to figure out what two numbers add to give us negative 8 that are the same number, and that's a negative 4. So x minus 4 squared, and what two numbers add to give me negative 6 that are the same, and that's a negative 3. So y minus 3 squared. Now when I rewrote this left-hand side as x minus 4 squared and y minus 3 squared, I added extra values into this left-hand side. Let's figure out what those values were. Well, x minus 4 times x minus 4, when I FOIL that out, I'll get x squared minus 8x plus 16. So I added a 16, and for my y minus 3 times y minus 3, that'll be y squared minus 6y plus 9. And I also added a 9. So on my right-hand side of my equation, I need to add 16 and add 9. So now I'll have x minus 4 squared plus y minus 3 squared equals negative 16 plus 16, which is 0, plus 9 is 9. So now I can figure out h, k, and r because I'm in standard form for an equation of a circle. So x minus h, x minus 4, so h is 4, y minus k, y minus 3, so k is 3, and r squared is equal to 9. So if I take the square root of both sides, I'll get that my r value is equal to a positive 3. So the center of my circle occurs at point 4, 3, so that's positive 4 in the x and positive 3 in the y, and my radius, r, is 3. So drawing a few points on the edge of my circle, 3 up, 3 to the right, 3 down, and 3 to the left, and then connecting those points. So with the center of 4, 3, and a radius of 3, I've sketched the graph for my circle and number 8. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to continue on to the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 9 through 14. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.